Welcome to the 2016 Art and Apples Festival here at Rochester Municipal Park. My name is Megan Stone and I am the artist manager. The Art and Apples Festival is Paint Creek Center for the Arts' signature annual fundraiser that helps keep our art center running all year long. We have so much going on. We have 287 artists in 18 different mediums. We have the Kids Art Zone where you can make a masquerade mask, get a tattoo, or climb the rock wall. We have a pie baking competition with lots of apple desserts. We have a kids chalk art competition where kids K through 12 can display their artwork on the sidewalk and get it judged. We have performances throughout the whole festival featuring all different kinds of music and dance performances. We have two food courts featuring international foods and traditional fair foods. It's a great stroll through the park, seeing all of the artists and having a good time.
My name is Ron Schmidt. I'm from Tequesta, Florida. And I'm here in Rochester doing the Arts and Apples Art Show. I do steel wall sculptures, all done with cut masonry nails. 48 years ago, I was in the corporate world in Chicago when one of my clients sold welding equipment. At the end of a meeting one day, he made me an offer on a welding unit that I couldn't refuse financially, and the rest is history. I assemble the nails in various geometric patterns and blast them. Wire brush them and either lacquer them or powder coat them. It's all done with cold rolled steel nails. It dates back to colonial days before they had the ability to make the wire nail, which is really a 20th century invention. They used to have to make their nails by shearing them off of plates of steel, and that's where the name cut comes from.
My name is Lene May. I believe this might be my sixth year in Rochester Art and Apples. One of my favorite shows, and my work is fiber arts, non-wearable fiber arts. And I have been doing elfin Christmas stockings for over 10 years now. A lot of new designs this year. My Sugar Plum Fairy, it has been one of my favorites lately to work on. I've been inspired by the Fabergé eggs. And Fabergé did so many amazing things just using a simple egg. And the elfin boot is such a simple design, but I can make crazy things. And they're evolving. And my new inspiration is vintage circus posters, and it seems to be my little cohesive muse that I'm using these days.
Okay, well, this is our first time in this lovely town. My sister-in-law, who's lived here almost all of her life, and so we know the community. Always enjoyed coming and enjoying the downtown area, particularly at the holidays. My wife and I are both jewelers. We've been doing this for almost 30 years full-time, and we really enjoy making primarily one-of-a-kind pieces using unusual materials, free-form pearls, unusual forms of copper, and natural stones. And so I'm always looking for new materials that by their nature don't allow doing the same piece twice. And I rely very heavily on the subconscious triggering of concepts that didn't exist before. And our cases are divided into series of small groupings of different types of material. And each of them reflect one of these epiphanies where I suddenly decided here's a direction I want to take.
So my name's Chris Goog, and I've come from Fort Lauderdale, Florida to bring this state of Michigan my underwater photography. Now, everything I shoot is strictly underwater, which includes the waves that are right behind me, kind of like a surfer's perspective of what's going on, all the way to turtles and whales and even the underwater swimming pigs of the Bahamas. I'm strictly self-taught. I've got more than 10, maybe 11,000 dives now, and I've been doing this full-time since I was 15 years old. So I think the further away from the ocean that people are, the more they need my work in their homes. It just reminds them how beautiful the ocean is and how important it is to get away on that 1 week a year vacation, whether it's to Florida or Fiji. But really, my portfolio is more than 40 countries, and most people can't even tell where they're from. So a lot of my photos are very placeless. It's just more to bring the beauty of the ocean into your home rather than a specific place.
We're looking forward to a great show here. It's really got the admiration of a lot of our friends who are also jewelers and artists who have done it for years, and they're the ones that convinced us to give it a shot.
Well, over the last 25 years, I've been here probably 15, 18 times. It gets a great crowd, and it does have a very high rating, and it's worthwhile coming back for.
I love coming up here. This is one of the best festivals in the country. Good enough to bring people like me all the way from Florida.
I'm seeing all of these lovely things around me, some of them brand new. I can't wait to take a few minutes to go out and see what they have myself. So I would say definitely come out. It's very well attended show. Artists are here. They're everywhere.
You can find more information online at pccaart.org. The festival is running all weekend long, September 9th to the 11th.